Welcome to another presentation about the Carolina Bays. This video introduces a goodness of fit measure for ellipses that is independent of the number of sample points and that is scaled to the size of the ellipse to allow comparison of the fitting errors for ellipses of different sizes. In 2022, I uploaded to GitHub a Python program that fits ellipses to the Carolina Bays by the least squares method. GitHub is a proprietary developer platform that allows developers to create, store, manage, and share their code. My intention was to allow geologists and other scientists to convince themselves that well-preserved Carolina Bays have a mathematically elliptical geometry. The program outputs the dimension and the azimuth of the ellipse, but up to now the program has not provided a goodness of fit measure. My strategy for calculating the goodness of fit measure was to calculate the angle of each point relative to the center of the ellipse and then find the intersection point of a line at that angle on the ellipse. Using the Pythagorean theorem developed 2,500 years ago allows us to calculate the error distance. The square of the hypotenuse of a right triangle is equal to the sum of the squares of the two other sides of the triangle. We have the equation for an ellipse and a line that goes through the sample point and the center of the ellipse. I consulted Gemini artificial intelligence to provide a way to find the intersection point. Gemini generated a Python program that was supposed to identify the intersection points at various angles going through the center of the ellipse. The suggested solution did not work. The code did not give the correct location of the intersection point on the ellipse. I spent a lot of time trying to verify if I had introduced an error in the code, but the code just did not work. I went back to Gemini and rephrased my question in more precise terms. This time, the AI program suggested using a numerical solver and provided some Python code. I tested the sample code on a single sample point, and it worked. I then incorporated the code into my program. Another problem that I had to solve was to make sure that the trigonometric functions of the Python code could give me angles from 0 to 360 degrees relative to the center of the ellipse for the sample points. I had to adjust the values obtained from the trigonometric functions depending on the quadrant relative to the center of the ellipse. As you can see in this example, the angle obtained by the arctan function for a point in the third quadrant is the same as the angle for the first quadrant. To get the correct value, I had to add 180 degrees when the point was in the third quadrant. Standard measures of fitness, like the mean squared error, did not provide meaningful comparisons for ellipses of different sizes. I had to define an error measure that was independent of the number of sample points and the size of the ellipse. I started with the error distance between the observed points and points on the ellipse. From this, I calculated the average error, which is the sum of all the error distances divided by the number of points. I finally defined the fitting error as the percentage of the average error relative to the semi-minor axis of the ellipse, which is half the width of the ellipse. Dividing by the semi-minor axis basically scales the average error to a proportion of the ellipse to allow comparisons of the fitting errors for ellipses of different sizes. I ran the program on approximately 60 digitized images, and as expected, well-preserved Carolina bays like those near Bowmore, North Carolina, were found to have a mathematically elliptical geometry with an average fitting error of 1.59%. The image from Kaczorowski's 1977 thesis, where he claimed that the model lake changed from circular to elliptical, was digitized using WebPlot Digitizer. The fitting error was 4.645%, which is much higher than the fitting errors for the Carolina Bays. In general, Carolina Bays have fitting errors of less than 3%. I also wanted to compare the fitting errors of the Carolina Bays with the fitting errors of the thermokarst lakes in Chile, which have often been compared to the bays. I had sample points for the perimeter of an oval lake in this region that I had previously digitized. The lake was surrounded by other irregular lakes. This thermokarst lake had a fitting error of 5%. In general, the ellipse fitting procedure with the fitting error calculation can be used to distinguish Carolina Bays from other geological structures that are claimed to be like the bays. Most computer programs have some defects that tend to show up under unusual conditions. This LiDAR image shows some Carolina Bays shaped like guitar picks because they were in place in sloping terrain. The unusual shape was formed when the upper part of the bay collapsed into the bay cavity during viscous relaxation when the bay formed. As a result, only the bottom part of the bay is elliptical, as can be shown by fitting it with an ellipse. However, the fitting error is 63.7% because the program did not identify the intersection points correctly. The Python program uses an iterative numerical method to find the solution that requires an initial guess to provide a starting point for the iterations. A good initial guess can lead to faster convergence and a higher chance of finding the correct solution. The convergence clearly failed in this case. When I provided the program with a different initial guess, the iterative process converged on the right answer and had a fitting error of 0.94%. After testing many examples without problems, I did not want to change the code and risk making a change that could get wrong results for many other examples. The program is not perfect, but it is still a useful tool. Thank you for joining me in the study of the Carolina Bays. Ask your geology professors to discuss the Carolina Bays because they are the most prevalent geological structures in the Atlantic coastal plain. There is a link to the LiDAR visualization tool by Michael Davies in the description of the video. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays and other scientific topics.